that when we're having.
What you're going to do is it gave you a meal today. Can you please throw your arms out for me? Perfect. Not quite really hard, but I ought to get it. You can try harder than that. No? You're not joking, don't you? Yeah, if you want to place your arm now, place your palm up. You guys are going to turn this fire and air. Can we place some note in your hand? Just place a few fingers over it. And thank you very much. That's your life.
So as soon as he's in the water, Murray can't help himself.
He's going to come over and defend his home to the water with everything he's got. And you be good, we'll get down. I seem a little bit nervous over here, but I am. There's a strike. Now you can understand why I look like a teeth. That's why I'm a little bit nervous. In those doors, why don't you punch that in a minute? Oh, there it goes. On a crocodile Murray's size, he would potentially have over 4,000 pounds per square inch of your door, but you're in a couple of them.
You're
the plan right
now.
They can't chew his food on weekends, he doesn't have to swallow it whole, so he's got to sort of juggle it around to get into the right spot. The 4,000 pounds per square inch, there is more jaw pressure than any other animal on the planet. And things like lions, tigers, great white sharks, they're around 400 up to about 1,000 pounds per square inch. No other animal even comes close to that sort of jaw pressure. So basically means, if Murray were to grab a mean meat body today, even if he didn't have a single tooth in his mouth, he would crush me down to a couple of centimetres thick. I would blow out of the room like a chicken toothpaste. That would make a great demonstration for you guys. But really at my weekend. So we're not going to do that. But Croc's and Dave is in the water, and at the water's edge, there is another area he can come into conflict with a crocodile. And that's an area that's overhanging the water. And that's your cue to come down this way, big guy. Thank you. And Dan, you can take care of that one.
Oh!
You might notice with his arms in that water there, when he's back, he's exposed, he's cheating right now. It actually won't cause a ripple or a bubble, but that's good, all those arms and bumps on his back, they're called osteodermal, plates. Basically, they cause currents and countercurrents, so they cancel each other out. So it doesn't matter how big or how small your crocodile is, you could have a 40 metre crocodile if it ever existed. As long as his back is covered, he wouldn't be surfing the surface. Now, the next thing we're going to show you guys, what we call the tail walk. Now, this isn't a circus trick that we've taught Murray or any of the crocodiles here at the zoo. It's actually natural behaviour. Crocs will do this when they hatch out of an egg. We're out 15 centimetres long. They'll be taking, at that size, they'll be taking down frogs and insects and small lizards. Anything kind of overhanging those reeds that these guys will be able to take down. Now, they'll tail walk to Murray size and even bigger. Now, watch his back legs and plant them on the ground. Your eyesight's very good and orientated, so you pop up, you can have a bit of a look. Tilt that head up, keep bending that tail. It's going to propel that body vertically up and out of the water. See how we go. Murray's a bit of a champion of this. Oh, good boy. Give it up for Martin, guys. How good is that?
Yeah,
clean a little bit of tension there. Get him out of the deep water. Now you can imagine if you're hanging over a branch, you're ringing, you're walking, you're flicking a lure. Be careful of this. The crocodile because they can't tail walk. They have been known to pluck a duck mid-flight over the river system. Getting into the deep section, here we go again. Watch that tail. He's looking at my head.
That really stuck. That really stuck.
Woo! Give it up for him, guys. How good was that? And you heard that little jaw pop there. That's that jaw pressure Jeremy was talking about. Well, that gets breathing out of the mouth. Because there is closing jaw pressure. So let that be a lesson for you. You are
up
in Australia, always be wary of that
tail walking
crocodile.
So Croc territory is not here on the Sunshine Coast. You do have to travel up into northern Queensland. Quite simply continues all the way up over the top end of Australia, all the way down to Broome in western Australia.
Let's get Murray out one more time. Get to see how far you can really go in the parts on the ground. Oh, you're kicking it.
Oh,
this is flat out.
Oh.
Good boy.
Bravo!
Like I was just saying, that was flat out from around the hard side of ground. Really, not that hard to see why. He's got four short, stubby little legs. He's got a big fat belly. A little bit like Jez over there. And then, except for Jez doesn't have this big tail like Murray has. Half a body length out of land. He's going to drag that everywhere he goes. As you can see, you're only a few minutes away from him. He's not really doing much. I probably even have a seat down here in front of me. Why not do anything? I said, what?
Yeah, who wants to see Jeremy sit down in front of a crocodile?
You're not going to invite today. goes straight back to the water. That's where he knows he's dangerous, and so he has the advantage. Bottom line is, staying safe from Crocs is simple. All you have to do is stay 4 to 5 meters back to the edge of the water. You're out of that initial strike range. Now obviously, don't go swimming with them, stay out of the water, and definitely don't ever hang in the water. You're never going to be confident with a large male saltwater crocodile.
In Australia, the saltwater crocodile is our apex predator. They play a vital role in our ecosystems, making sure our waterways stay healthy and resilient.
And how will you live? They're ripping out one of the last living links to the dinosaur era. 260 million years in the making, and unchanged for the last 65 million years.
Yeah, that's exactly right. Now, I expect you guys to go away today loving crocodiles like we do. But if you'd love to get involved in croc research and all the croc stuff that we do here at the zoo, there's going to be a bit of a clip shown at the end of this demonstration. It's going to have a little bit about the Steve Irwin Wildlife Reserve. And if anyone would love to come up and join us this year on our annual crocodile research trip, there'll be a lot of information on the clip. Just log on to the website, we might see you up there this year. But with that in mind, I'd like to thank you all for coming here today, helping us keep Steve's dream and his plan alive.
And now it's your turn, ladies and gentlemen. Get out there, live a little on the wild side, and always remember, Crocs rule!
Thanks for coming, everyone.